Why did I call it Stuff Your Muff Farm? That was a different bear back then, man. I don't think there was even a reason. That was just the first thing that came to mind, I think. All right. I'll put myself on blast a bit. Yo, McLaffy Taffy. Thank you, man. Welcome, everybody. Perfect timing, actually. McLaffy Taffy Raiders here. Just joining us for the slash marker for the YouTube VOD. So welcome back, everybody, to Stardew Valley. I'm a Stardew Valley noob. I have played probably a grand total of like 2 hours of this, including... Well, no, I suppose we played 3 last time. So let's call it 4 total hours of Stardew Valley experience in my life. And this is the first time I've gotten past like the initial starting obstacles of not knowing how to recover your energy effectively, not really knowing how to make any money. I'm starting to figure that out. It feels pretty good. So let's keep going with it. Thank you for the raid, man. Appreciate it. Got a brisket over temp in the smoker. Oh boy. You're gonna get our food conversation started immediately today? I usually at least have like a 20 to 30 minute window of non-food commentary before I started making everybody hungry. I lost my favorite axe. If you find it, please return ASAP. I am having a tough time without it. 250 gold for whoever finds the thing. So here's the thing, Robin. Oh, hold on. I gotta go say hi to Chubbs. I forgot I have Chubbs now. Oh, there's my buddy. Hello. Oh, he's just gonna get a bug. Chubbs bold. I didn't mean to smack him with a club. No. Stop it. Okay, we gotta put the club away. Clearly, it's my good.
A renewal. Welcome back.
Sorry for beating you over the head with a mallet, man. I didn't mean to do that to start the day. X-side. Thank you for the prime. Welcome on back in. Give him some bear hugs, please. Appreciate it. Anyway, like I was gonna say to Robin, kinda depends on the quality of the axe there, fella, because if that thing's worth more than 250, you bet your bottom gill I'm keeping it. I would not mind an upgrade to our axe, actually. I'm pretty sure I'm not able to take out these stumps still, so yeah, anything that can do that, I'd very much like to see. I feel like I ought to go ahead and try to focus a little bit more on the actual farmland this time around, though, so let's get to work. Let's actually start planting some crops, shall we? Suppose I need to water this stuff today, too. Sprinkler's still not really in the cards. I'm trying to decide what should be the next big priority right now. I'm assuming it's probably going to be some equipment upgrades. The ability to clear out the rest of the stuff in here, I'm assuming it's going to come via the copper tools. Which aren't too far away. They're just a little expensive, but so long as we got a decent economy going, it shouldn't be too far out of reach. He's getting a few more bear hugs as well. Moody Mollusk. Thank you, Moody, for the tier 2 for 41 months. Glad to have you back. Appreciate it. Let's water these crops we've actually gotten here before I forgot to, or before I forget as well. Please show him the love from the pile. Thank you very much for the support. Appreciate it. This is pleasant, man.
Welcome back.
I'm very glad. This feels a lot like it felt when I was first getting into RimWorld back in the day. Oh, we got potatoes. Nice. Didn't realize those were good to go. Wonder how much those are worth. Otter de los Muertos. The 4 full years. Welcome back, Otter 2. Appreciate it. This feels a lot like RimWorld in that I know that there's... That we're only really scratching the surface here in that... We're going to be looking forward to a lot more good times with this. Okay. I do want to get back to the caves as well. I was having fun with that. I guess I shouldn't just sit here. I'm feeling the pressure now of the clock going as I sit here trying to make choices. Although maybe that's against the spirit of the game. Maybe I shouldn't worry too much about speed running, you know? It's a marathon, buddy. God, this is so pleasant now, too. I really like that we got this wood path down, although I'm pretty sure I actually missed a tile right there with it. Do I have wood in my inventory? No, I do not. Well, let's not worry about it. We'll fix it later. This game's more about finding your own pace. Yeah, for sure. I gotta adopt that mentality big time. You don't want to complete the community center year one? I want to get all the achievements in 45 minutes or less. If I can't do that in a game, why even bother? Just want a pure dopamine blast. And then we move on to the next product. Have I even gone in here yet? Oh, this is the museum. That's right. We actually have a few things for this guy, don't we? I don't think I brought any of them with me. Yeah, they're probably back in my chest at home. We'll deal with that at some point. I wanted to go to the seed store today. For sure. Mostly just meandering to see if there's maybe some more townsfolk that we haven't run into yet. I bet there's a couple people in the store. I haven't talked to this guy yet. Morris. Welcome to Jojo Mart. I don't believe we've met. I'm Morris, Jojo Customer Satisfaction Representative. When you decide you want to become a JoJo member, I'll be delighted to help make your transition a joyous experience. You sound like a robot. When's the last time someone gave you a hug, buddy? Let's talk to this guy, too. Shane's hard at work, and he doesn't seem interested in talking. You also just attacked him, so I'm sure he's a little concerned about that. Oh, that's Pam, right? Okay. That did count, I think, toward our meeting everybody, though, I'm assuming, right? Introductions? Ooh, we only have to meet two more people. Gotta look out for them. Frick this guy, apparently, yeah. No, I've already become anti-JoJo-pilled via just the conversations I've been having with people about having started this again. Well, that backpack upgrade's probably going to be pretty tempting early on, too. All right, let's see. More taters? Jazz. Produce a blue puffball flower. Interesting. I wonder why I would want to plant grass? I guess for fiber. Yeah. Okay. You got your sugar, your wheat flour. I'm looking forward to baking at some point. Well, let's go ahead and grow some cauliflower. Get a little bit of that. We'll get like four of those, I guess. And then let's do five more beans and 15 parsnips. And then like five potatoes. Yeah, that feels good. Feels like a good trip to Pierre's. Apparently the update adds new stuff to the JoJo run, so I may have to try it again, but I won't like it. It's essentially the villain route, right? Because as far as I understand it, the whole vibe here is small town gets injected with a parasitic corporation, and every villager all of a sudden becomes a white blood cell determined to stamp out the disease. And then it's up to you as the player character to decide what team you want to join. And, you know, it's pretty clear at least where the morality lies with that. But who knows? Maybe it's more fun to be a dick. None of us would, because we play video games and we never choose those options. Raise your hand if you've ever been a dick in a video game. Like in any situation, in any instance in which you are presented with either like a dialogue option or an action choice, and it's clear to you that if you chose the way, or like chose a particular way, that way is the way of the dick. And you chose that because I don't know if I ever have. I can't bring myself to do it. I don't want to hurt these poor people. They're real people with real feelings. Punch the Mass Effect 3 reporter. Well, that person's just evil. They're chaotic evil. You're justified in that. You're actually a hero for that. Everybody did that. Cough, cough, Fable. Okay, yeah, maybe that's that's gonna be the exception. You just sort of end up a dick no matter what in that game. Bullshit, you play the dick to giggle at the reactions. But I would never do it, like, earnestly. It is funny sometimes to see how they respond. But if I'm doing a real playthrough, I'm always the nice guy. I can't help it. I want them to like me. It's not out of a sense of morality. It's out of a desperate need to be liked. I'm a Twitch streamer, for God's sake. You know that about me. Hey, Pawn. Yeah, these are going to YouTube for sure, Tony. Conveniently already have an Indie Mouse thumbnail from yesteryear for it. Although I am tempted to see what Cho's rendition of this would be. Good old Farmer Baer. Use an update. I might hit her up for that. Alright. That feels way better. Let's have a potato. I earned it. Eat that sucker raw. Chow down on it like an apple. Yum yum. Alright, we're actually growing stuff. Incredible. And it's 6 o'clock in the evening. I feel like a real farmer. Alright, great. Now the work's all done and it's time for bed. Let's get up in the morning and do it all again. Except, no, we still got some time. I could probably chop down trees or something. Did you ever do Detroit Become Human? I did, yeah. I don't remember a lot of it. I remember being kind of disappointed by the lack of freedom, really, in that game, though. I don't really know why I'm surprised. It was kind of sold as being fairly linear. That was my Heavy Rain experience, because I never actually played Heavy Rain. I just watched other people play it. So I had to get that one fresh out the box. I was disappointed with the lack of game. Yeah, that's kind of fair. It's pretty much just a movie you click through. This is beautiful, though. I'll give him that. Plus, it's got the dude from... Ah, oh, man. What's he in?
A renewal. Welcome back.
ER? He's in one of those medical dramas, right? The real pretty dude? The shaved head?
Welcome back.
Kitten Ray! Thank you very much for the resubscription. Welcome back in. Continuing the gifty from Angel of Iron. Appreciate that. And Prof. Kittimus with the 41 months as well. Grey's Anatomy. Thank you. Yeah, I like that dude. He's solid. Otherwise, didn't really retain a lot from it, as you can tell. Oh, yeah. Brian Descartes, right? Is how you say that? Descartes? Or I don't know how to say his last name, but yeah, he was great, too. He was the, Boy, yeah, I can hardly remember anything from that game. He was wasn't he one of the main guys, right? Or he was the... God, yeah, it's all a blur now. That was so long ago. Baer, that came out last year. Oh! Connor, yeah, that sounds right. That sounds right. All right, I'm gonna chop down, like, two more trees here and then put our extra stuff away and come back out ready to hit the mines, I think, in the morning. Yeah, glad to have you, Prof. Thank you. Appreciate the resub. Met his wife making the game because she's also in it. That's dope. Cool. Okay, good day. I actually have some plants ready in the morning, too. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, yeah, we have potato seeds still. Oh, my goodness. Didn't even plant these guys yet. Hold on. I'm not really doing a great job organizing, but That's for later. We just plant for now. Wonderful. That's a great day. It's a very effective use of our time. I'm pleased with that. And there's a widow chub. Oh, he's even closer to the bed. You can get on the bed, buddy. It's okay. There's enough room for both. Snuggle right up, bud. All right. Not making any money today.
A renewal. Welcome back.
That's all good. All about the progress. Real angry bones. Thank you for the 29 months. Welcome on back in. Appreciate it. Bear hugs, please, for them as well. It's the Egg Festival tomorrow. You should arrive between 9 and 2 p.m. if you'd like to attend. You wouldn't want to miss the annual egg hunt. Boy, wouldn't I. Put me on the itinerary, my friend. I'm there. All right. Single potato. Let's get to watering. Yeah, that sprinkler is definitely feeling like something I ought to prioritize a little bit more early here, considering. Let's just look, honestly. Yeah, it's... Clock it in, 6:30 a.m. is when we start watering the plants. Let's see how long this process actually takes. It is satisfying. I won't say that much about it. As time-consuming as it is, it does feel good. Upgraded watering can is huge early. Oh, I bet that hits more than one tile, huh? Okay, yeah, that could be the way to go. That may be... It's probably a little cheaper, too, I imagine, than the sprinkler setup. Look at my chubs. Can I get a bear chubs? Anytime you see this dog, you just feel free to let those bear chubs fly. And any bear chub... Any opportunity to use the bear chubs emote is a great one. Alright, a little over an hour to water all the crops. That's not terrible, but... We feel like we could speed that up a bit. Did it turn off between sessions? It shouldn't have. No, I'm pretty sure it's there, right? Yeah, I got the little red box there. All right, we have successfully watered. I think it's time to hit the caves. Let's go get some copper. It's a northern lion hunt, you know it. He's in everything now. He's like the cranberry juice of indie game features. Daytime vibes, baby. Gotta love it. I really do want to build this path. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it right now. Do what you want. Do what your heart desires, Bear. It's your game. Live your truth. Don't chop these trees down, though. These are for the squirrels. They like these ones. Let's maybe do it with your own trees. We'll get our own wood. We got plenty of that to spare. I don't want to destroy this beautiful nature out here. We'll do it next time. Later on, Zen. Alright, so we're still trying to get down to floor 40, I want to say it is. Here in the mines. See if we can manage to knock out a few of those today. Getting here nice and early, at least. That should be good. We gotta kill a bunch of slimes and bugs. I want to say it was like in the hundreds for either one. To impress some... Loof Senior in the Adventurers Guild. Ow. This is new. Another bug meat. Hey, welcome, Soul. It's 1,000? Oh, boy. 1,000 bugs. Yeah, that does sound more accurate. These guys are just gonna show up every now and then. Alright, let's find that ladder. Can reveal itself. So there is no real visual tell about where the ladder is under the rocks, is there? Just a matter of random chance, I guess. Bugs is like 80, slimes is 1,000. Ah, okay. Well, something reachable early on, at least. Oh god. That's a good mimic. That's effective. Oh, nice. Marine crustacean with two powerful pincers. I probably should have brought some food. I didn't really think about that this time. I came unprepared today. That's unfortunate. Hopefully I can find some cave carrots. Oh, shit. Oh, god. Okay. That's new. And fun. Let's see. Give me that. No good. I'll just pop a potato real quick. Not bad. Oh. Cool. Got some coal out of that. Can I push it? Apparently not. Okay. Delicious bug meat. Yeah, I guess there's always that option, huh? Hey, friend. So glad we got this wood club. A huge boon early on. There's a couple of cave carrots. Pop this guy real quick. Yum, yum, yum. Yeah, that's pretty effective, actually. Nice. A raw potato a day will do you wonders. That's what doctors recommend. Yeah, I'm really struggling to find a potato rhyme. I thought it would be quick. A potato a day keeps the tomato away. Yeah, no, I'm struggling. I don't know where you land with it. Honk. I'm gonna kill everything, right? The portable cooking kit is something I just remembered. It's a new thing. I think I've unlocked that, haven't I? I have a campfire. I have a cookout kit. A cooking campfire on the go. Yeah, I think that's what that is. I should bring some wood and fiber next time, I guess. Keeps Play-Doh at bay. We're in a cave after all. Sure. Are you saying Play-Doh like the philosopher or Play-Doh like the thing? Wait, what's Play-Doh made of? Because it's not clay. It's clay-like. It's clay-adjacent. Play-Doh's made of Play-Doh, Bear. Salt? Okay. Hold on. I have to Google it. Inquiring minds must know. The Play-Doh Wikipedia page. It is actually just salt. A pliable putty-like substance. They wanted a product that could clean coal residue from wallpaper. That's why this was made. That was its original purpose. Water, salt, and flour. Wow. You could probably make your own Play-Doh, couldn't you? Play-Doh any color if you make it at home. I wonder if I can chop those vines down. Then eat and have rainbow shits. Oh, fun. I had to stop myself from even vocalizing the idea that possibly I have to find a way to dance around actually saying it too, like that might be a product you can actually consume and you're fine. Don't eat the Tide Pods. Have some Play-Doh instead. I've been all about the hot takes lately, haven't I? Yeah. Go away. Go away. Go away. Man, this ladder's gonna be tough. Huh. Alright, get to work, I guess. Let's pre- particularly rough that... Oh, well, never mind. Stop complaining, buddy. You'll be all right. Preschool snack poll, Play-Doh, or Elmer's glue. No shame in it, but did you ever eat glue or paste as a kid? I'm just sincerely curious. Anybody who can cop to that, I just got a couple questions. It's just why? Like, what was it about it that made it appetizing? Because I never had that thought as a child of like, that looks good. It's tasty, is it? The taste you fool. Well, my bad, Ryan. I'm not as cultured. I didn't have as developed of a palate back then, I guess. Go try it, you coward. I mean, all right, sure. Yeah, I'll do anything to boost viewership at this point. A little paste and Play-Doh date. How many gifties to eat an entire thing of craft glue, Baer? Baer's glue tier list. Yeah, we'll have a bracket of the best non-food substance to consume. I don't know, man. Like, I'm trying to think of like what my closest analog would be as a child of like the weirdest thing that I wanted to eat. I feel like I ate paper as a kid at some point. I think I did that. I don't think I did it for long. I just wanted to know what it felt like, I guess. Dry cat food here. I tried it. Wasn't too bad, actually. I fully believe there are some cat and dog foods that actually don't taste bad. That I would be okay eating a serving of. Treats, too. There we go. I ate tissue when I was a kid? That's pretty similar. Similar argument for it as well, I guess. Although, that's gotta feel a little weird going down. Here's just a straight-up gross thing I used to do as a kid. To the point where you may even want to cover your ears if you're easily squeamish. It's upsetting. It's not that bad. It's not that bad. I just wanted to prepare you properly. But I also wanted to find out if there was anybody like me that used to do this. You ready? Okay, I gave you proper time to prepare. Hello, Baer. Hello, Chad. Oh, no. Okay, for the people that literally just arrived, close your ears. Because I'm about to describe the time as a kid when I used to eat string cheese by swallowing as much of a string of the string cheese as I could, holding it like this, and then pulling it back up out my throat. I'm sorry. I know. It's upsetting. Who didn't do that? Yeah. I figured it was fairly common, at least. It's like the infinite beer. It's the never-ending string cheese. It's a perma-snack. I'm running out of energy. I respect it. I had to come clean. I put everybody else on the spot. It was only fair. Had to make the paste eater still feel welcome. Alright, you can uncover your ears now. You're safe. Still can't hear me. It's okay now! I won't mention it again. The fact that I used to deep throat string cheese. What? No! You found an artifact. The curator of the local museum might want to know about this. Cool. That's fun. Topaz. Gunther can tell you more about this. Ancient seed. Nice. Oh, this is a rice shoot seed. Too cool.
No.
Oh, whoops. Sorry. Hit the wrong button. Boop. There we go. My bad. Okay, we're back to here. Hit this. There we go. Okay, we're probably going to need to go pretty soon. Oh my god, it's 11:30. Holy shit. Let's get going. I got a little distracted by the conversation. Yeah, we're not able to go much deeper tonight. Let's get the heck out of the mine. Glad I spotted that, dude. Good copper ore haul, maybe enough for a new watering can. How much did we end up getting there? 30's pretty good, yeah. I want to look into that. Let's go ahead and put away all those goodies for the museum. So I don't forget to do that. Kind of curious how much this crab is going to sell for. I think I'll put that in the sell box. And then hang on to our cave carrot. Hang on to our bug meat until I've got a better idea of what to do with it. And then we know we had a couple of crafting recipes that involve coal as well. I think that was the portable campfire, if I recall correctly. And then we need some wood for that as well, so we should bring some of that up next time too. Yeah, this is my first full playthrough here, Jade. I've dabbled a little bit, but never really gotten this far with it. Could sell the stone too, that'd be fine probably. I'm gonna plant this rice shoot as well. And then keep that for now, sell that, put the fiber away, put the copper away. Not sure what to do with the quartz yet, but we'll probably give it to Gunther. Okay, that's gonna be you. And then, well, I mean, we're probably able to build some stuff out of the stone as well. For now, I think just let me go at my own pace here, Jade. I'm sure I'll ask questions if I need help. Appreciate you asking. Oh, yeah, we got the sap as well. I feel like we don't have a lot we're doing with the sap. Let's sell, like, half of that stack. Is there a faster way to split a stack like this instead of just right-clicking individual ones? And then that might be good for now. We don't really need a ton of money. We're growing a lot of cash coming in soon anyway. And then plant this guy. Make sure you get him watered. All right, just in time. Right before I collapse from exhaustion. Good stuff. Oh, cool. Staircase crafting recipe and +1 pickaxe proficiency. 100 bucks for a crab, wow. Damn, dude, okay. I have to do a little more fishing. Seems like a good way to mix up the patterns too, actually. Gameplay loops. So I'm just stuck in Infiniminer. Couple of taters ready. Parsnip. Still waiting on them beans. Let's get to watering. Might as well accept that's routinely going to be the start of our day here. No problem with that. Oh, here you go, Baer. Here's a genius move. A little time saver. Just stand in the center. I don't know why I haven't thought to do that yet. Especially because you guys confirmed for me last time, if you could just double confirm for me the fact that walking over your plants doesn't actually, like, hurt them, right? These poor little guys, I wouldn't want to cause them any harm. That's correct, cool. Good news. We got anti-boot protection, alright, yeah, good. Some high quality seeds, man. Yeah, that was a little speedier. Let's go visit Gunther. Let's bring a bunch of stuff to Gunther and see if we can't get some benefit out of that. So we've got the ancient seed, the topaz. Let's go with the quartz, earth crystal, jade. And hey, he wants my old rusty sword too, who knows. See you later, Shubs. Oh, you know what? Let me bring that wood, too. So I can make that path if I wanna. Yep. There we go. Oh, also the coal. So we can make a camping kit. In fact, before I go, let's make some snack bars. Or at least one. I'm gonna bring that, and then bring some fiber as well. And we're definitely gonna have to stop by Gunther's first so we can clear out some inventory space before we go on a camping trip. Oh yeah, we can make a cookout kit. Maybe we should just make that. Just make the one of those, and then that's probably all we'll really need. We can leave the fiber and the coal behind. And then we already made a snack bar, so let's put the other stuff away too. Boom, and that'll do it. Cool. All right, moving on. Today's festival is being set up. Oh yeah, I forgot. It's Egg Day. Oh, so much for those plans. We'll visit Gunther in a bit. Time for the egg festival. Got all those lined up and ready just as soon as we need them, though. Well, I guess we're killing 30 minutes until that time comes. Let's chop down some more pine trees. See if we can get some snack bars made up. It's egg day. Everybody's favorite day. Oh, shit. It's already here. Want to be late. See you, Chubbs. I'm off to the egg hunt. Oh, baby. It was a party, dude. Our hens have been working overtime to prepare for this festival. They deserve the best tonight. Bowls full of sweet yellow corn. Hopefully this will be the opportunity to meet anybody I haven't met yet. Is there any more food? I put something nice into the punch. Oh, Pam. No one really talks to me. I just come for the deviled eggs. What do you call this, Linus? Am I nobody? Hope everyone's enjoying the food. I've been cooking for days to get everything ready. Fried eggs, boiled eggs, poached eggs, deviled eggs, scrambled eggs, chocolate eggs, you name it. Chocolate egg? You're not talking about, like, a real egg covered in chocolate. He's talking about just, like, a chocolate or an egg-shaped chocolate. There's not a real... Ew. I've been up since dawn coloring eggs. It's always my favorite part of the season. Vincent loves this festival. It's a joy to see him so happy. Real egg filled with chocolate. Now we're talking. Eggs definitely have a place in a well-balanced diet. Yeah, I've been loving it, Lulu. Glad to have you. Welcome to the egg festival. Compliments of my wonderful brood of hens. Wait, come back, Demetrius, I always forget his name. Egg, what a strange thing to eat. How many names do I remember, actually? There's Pam. I literally just talked to him. I don't remember. There's Vaughn from Legend of Legaia. There's a Marcy somewhere. This guy's name is Ludwig. It's not, but I decided that. Oh, I haven't talked to you yet.
What's everyone so happy about? Eggs? Why eggs?
I don't think I've talked to him yet.
This festival has been a tradition for as long as I can remember. Tradition connects us with both the past and the future. It's comforting.
That's Sebastian. I know that one.
We used to do rotten egg toss. Mayor Lewis put an end to that pretty quick.
You would do a rotten egg toss.
My... those allergies.
man of my like.
Sometimes I hide an egg too well, no one finds it. Well, until summer rolls around, then the hot air starts to bring out the rotten smell.
I guess we're all bunched up in the middle. All right. Have I talked to the little boy yet? I think I did. Vincent. Yeah. I think I talked to him a couple times, actually. I always look forward to these gatherings. It makes the valley feel like a real community. Oh, eye patch dude. You're new. Right? Oh, no, I talked to him. That's right.
Even with my bad leg, I never miss a town festival.
There's got to be, like, one more person I haven't talked to, but I can't find him. All right, yeah, he's movie voice kid. I forgot. I got to commit to that bit, because it's my favorite bit that we're doing through this game so far. Spring is a busy time of year, so it's nice to have a day off to catch up with friends. There's a special egg day shop, by the way. Oh, yeah. How did I not notice that? Oh, fun. Strawberry seeds. Ooh. That sounds nice. A seasonal plant that doesn't need watering. Cool. Colorful set. Pastel banner. Let's get a couple of strawberries. Let's get 3 strawberries. That sounds nice. Let's get to hunting, I guess. How do we start it up? This festival's all right, but what I'm really looking forward to is the flower dance. I try to eat at least 3 eggs every day. Doctor recommended. That and a glue stick will sort out your nutrition. Talk to the mayor. That makes sense. Pop quiz, Baer. Which one's the mayor? This guy. That's right. Do you think everyone's ready for the egg hunt yet? Yeah, let's start.
It's time for the highlight of today's festivities. The annual spring egg hunt. Calm down now, kiddos. You're gonna need all your energy if you hope to find the most eggs and take home the exclusive prize. Exclusive.
Lewis, if you're gonna hold an egg fest, each opportunity for an egg pun must be taken. I'm gonna be firm on this.
Now, is everyone ready? Let the egg hunt begin!
Oh, we're going. All right, here we go. Let's find some eggs. I don't know how to find the eggs. I'm guessing just click on places and try to find eggs there. Gotta be bushes and trees, bushes and trees. Let's go where other folks aren't. Get our own little zone. Oh, there's one. Found it. Nice. Oh, you just pick them up. I see. How do I get back there, though? Do I have to go up and around or something? They're gonna find a way. Don't take my egg. That's my egg. There's no way up there. Oh, you have to click the egg. Okay, I see. Give me that. Oh, there's one. Yoink. It's an actual egg hunt. This is great. Oh, I have one right there. Damn it. I don't know, man. I don't know if I got enough.
Wow, look at all these eggs. Now, if only I could get you kids to pick up litter this efficiently, we'd have the cleanest town this side of the GMC. Now the winner of this year's egg hunt. Abigail! Ah, damn it!
fucking Abigail. Ah, every year.
Here's your prize, Abigail. Enjoy. Well, that's it for this year's Egg Festival. Thanks for coming, everyone.
Gotta wait till next year. Gotta wait till next year to redeem myself. Oh, it's 10. Okay. Well, chop down some trees, I guess. Enter the game files and delete Abigail from the system. That seems like a reasonable response. All right, that's a good thing to note, too, is apparently events will take the whole day. Still gonna do it, obviously, but good to know that. Go ahead and get rid of all this grass here, too. Has Dumbledore died yet? I killed him just to get out of the way. Yeah, I figured it'd be a point of contention if I didn't. And Snape. Just, you know, felt fair. Alright, that's probably good. Take out this guy and call it a night. Next year, Abigail's gonna be late to the hunt, yeah. Be a shame if something happened to her. My chubs. Oh, yes, weeby boy. He sleeps inside when it's raining. / stays inside when it's raining. That's good. That's excellent game design. I gotta get a little doghouse up there, dude. I want him living large. I don't have any plans to marry anyone, but it might happen. Who knows? Let's see how things go. Love the rain, man. Save me some time. Let's hit it. Oh yeah, we gotta go to Gunther's now. Oh, let's plant our strawberry seeds, too. Get these suckers going. Fun. Okay, eventually I'll divide my farm up so I'm actually aware of where things are, but doesn't seem like a huge priority yet. Let's see here. What am I putting away right now? Ooh, got a gold star potato. Nice. And some mixed seeds. Hold on a sec. I'm gonna plop this guy in there. And then, let's see. Got an energy bar. I'm gonna sell that potato just out of curiosity to see what kind of price we can get from that. I'll just sell the sap as well. And then I want to make another snack bar if I can. I don't think I actually have the resources for it, though. I need a pine cone and an acorn, right? Let's see if I can go get a pine cone real quick. Well, yeah, I'm probably fine. Might find another cave carrot or something. So, let's sell these potatoes and the parsnips. Got a cave carrot, put away the fiber, put away the wood. Actually, keep the wood so we can make a path. And then let's get all this stuff for Gunther. Nice. And we'll knock that out, and then we'll head up to the mines again. Oh, true. Yeah, I was going to upgrade the can. I don't know if I have the money for that, though. I think it's like 2,000 gold, isn't it? 2,000 gold and a certain amount of copper. We'll do that next time. Especially because I don't actually need the watering can today, although it would be good to prep for it tomorrow, I guess. Leaving these stray cans of open dog food out. Get it together, guys. The raindrops are really loud on the metal roof of our trailer, so I prefer to stay outside. God damn it. Stop it.
What? Abysmal. Not a single piece in the entire collection.
I got you covered, buddy.
What's this? You found something. Let me see it. Remarkable. It's very old. I'd love to study this in greater detail, but it is yours. I've got a favor to ask you. Would you consider donating any new artifacts or minerals that you find? We could make a groundbreaking discovery together. Oh, and who knows? If you keep donating, I might come across some interesting items to send your way. Think about it, will you? If you decide to donate, just bring the objects to the front desk. I believe I have decided to donate. What do we got? I'm guessing just everything. Oh, we get to decide the layout? What am I, the actual museum curator? I'm just doing his job. There you go, buddy. New reward. Oh, cool. And another one. What you got for us, buddy? Collect rewards. Ancient seeds. 9 cauliflower seeds and a recipe for ancient seeds. Nice. Let's go plant that bad boy. I'm gonna grow beanstalk. Go up and meet the giant. Get the golden goose. Break the game. Name it Frederick. Ride it around town. Dominate the egg hunt on gooseback next year.
Ew, it smells.
Why is it locked? I want to explore the sewers.
I think Gunther has the key.
Professor Gunther, the man who runs the museum. Why do you think he has it?
I saw a big rusty old key fall out of his pocket one time. A creepy sewer door like this has just gotta be a match for a big old rusty key.
It's fair logic.
Watch out, slime!
There's something moving around in there.
I got it. That's adorable. Okay. I didn't know you were the original voice actor for the kids. Yeah. Questionable direction they gave me for the boy, but I'm not gonna fight it. I'm just doing what I'm told. Sorry, I got gas. Is this something I can fix? Is that just a... I mean, it looks like it's going to be a bridge at some point. Okay, anyway. Don't want to waste too much time here. We got to get back to the mines. I got to plant my ancient seed. What does this want? Archaeology's done. Oh, nice. Wants to give me free money. Thank you. Don't mind if I do. Did I finish my introductions, too? I am still missing one single person.
Welcome back. Bad poetry golem.
So very close. I'm very excited to have you be likely our first member of the Papyrus team. Looking forward to seeing what I'm actually going to do for that. Get him some bear hugs, please. Thank you for the 99 months on the pile. It's going well, Dan. I'm digging it. All right, ancient seed. Let's see what you can do. Yeah, you get your own special little plot right here. And then a bunch more cauliflower. I can't remember if that's what this is, but seems like a fine place to put it anyway. Cool. Well, that's a really good horseradish, too. We'll save that for later. All right. Already noon, but still plenty of time to go spelunking. Papyrus team? I'll give it to you. Full points. Yeah, getting into it for the first time, thanks to the update, Golem, felt like a good excuse to give it another shot, and I'm very, very glad I did. I'll hit you with this scorching hot take again. I think Stardew Valley is a pretty good video game. I just felt just like people just floored. It's like on the ground, taken aback. Like, Jesus, Baer, you can't just say stuff like that. You gotta prepare us first. Good God. All right, off we go. We're down to like 15 now. Yeah, we're doing pretty good here. Making our way. Oh, cool. Thanks. I wonder if it did that because I already made it to this floor and it just gives you the thing right away. Kind of doubt it, but that'd be interesting. Oh, cool. Okay. Guess that's a thing they do. Oh, they hatch into the other guys. Interesting. Okay, okay. Just gotta try to kill them before they transform. 8 years old now, yeah, that's wild, dude. How many units is this game sold? Just out of curiosity. I feel like it's gotta be like 10 million or more. Is moved product for sure. Enough to make one nerd very wealthy and well deserved. Give him every penny, he earned it. Over 30 million across all platforms. Sheesh. Holy. That's even more than I thought, man. Wow. Yeah, that's wild. The fact he's still adding content when he didn't have to after all the success. He could have just fricked right off, dude. Absolutely. I would have been tempted to. I'm not going to lie. Right off in the damn sunset after that. I know, he's still working on it. He's still making another game. Like, he's clearly just passionate about it. That's dope. I bought 3 copies myself, PS4, Switch, and mobile. Oh, yeah, I forget it's on mobile, too. That's probably contributing to quite a bit. Yeah, this would be a great mobile game. Imagine having passion for things. Imagine loving what you do. Concept. Good. Yeah, I totally understand getting it on multiple platforms. That's, I've done that every now and then. Hell, I did that with, Balatro. And I'm almost certainly gonna buy a third copy of Balatro when it comes out on mobile. Did that with Hades. Yeah, same, actually. I think I got a copy of Hades on the Switch, too. Probably get a copy of Hades 2 on the Switch 2. Or the Switch Pro, or whatever they'll like call it. Boink. Slay the Spire for me. Oh yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, I got Slay the Spire on mobile too, actually, so I guess that also checks my box. Monster Train was one of your multi-platform. Still surprised that I bounced off that game as quickly as I did, because you'd think it would have been a lot more up my alley. what it is about it just didn't work for me. The new Switch is just called the Switched. Why not? Makes about as much sense as any other console name. It really does feel like Microsoft and Nintendo. Just like, why couldn't they? Well, no, it makes more sense for Nintendo, I guess. I'm more just mad at Microsoft. Which I feel is a fully justified anger for the direction they've gone with the name of their consoles. Like, genuinely, that's a lot of the reason, not a lot, but like it is a reason why I have not bought a new Microsoft console for over a decade. They feel like iterations on the same thing, despite the fact that you would think that, like, the thing literally just named PlayStation 2, 3, 4, and 5. You'd think that would be the case for that one, but no. At least they're changing the form factor with that. At least they're confusing you into believing you're getting a brand new system. The Xbox Series S, X, version X. Like, what are you doing? I know this is old hat. This is a conversation we've had before. But I'm still mad about it. Until they come out with something like the Xbox Prism. Or not even that, just call it a Prism. That's free, Mr. Microsoft. If you're listening, take it. Run with it. Apply some level of creativity to the process, please. The Hypercube, sure, why not? The Tesseract, yeah. There's so many good names. Literally anything else. No. Instead, we're getting a black rectangle named the console. That would be better if they named the console the console. That's how bad their current names are. That's where we're at. I don't think I can progress. Oh, that's weird. Huh, okay. I guess I have to strengthen my pickaxe first. All right, well, that'll force us to switch it up a little bit, I guess. Ugh. I thought I read they're not gonna make a new console. Yeah, well, good. They've lost their privileges anyway. Clearly, they've shown they don't know how. Just call it a box. Yeah, why not? Jesus. Well, underwhelming day in the mines, I guess. Although the timing kind of worked out. That was a very odd mine spawn. You should be able to progress. Oh, really? Just got unlucky, I guess. Nintendo really messed things up when they stole the name GameCube from the Xbox line. Yeah, when you put it that way, it does sound more like a Microsoft console. This is a cube you play games on. Enjoy it. Oh, sorry, pal. I didn't realize you were sleeping behind the door. Well, let me do a little inventory management again here. Oh, yeah. I got to take this to a blacksmith. Forgot about that. Some hardwood, some algae. Sweet. All right. I wanted to keep that, though. Got plenty of copper now. Let's go ahead and keep that in the inventory. Let's bring that over to blacksmith, who I am probably going to have to get a reminder of the location of. Oh, this is fun. Didn't realize you could change the color of the chest. I think I like the default one, though. Yeah, we're good. Well, I do need money, don't I? Maybe I could sell some of this stuff. I don't really want to, though. The sap would be the thing I'd want to sell the most, but even that's not going to be nearly enough. Yeah, that's to worry about in the morning. Let's go find out how much money I need. Set that goal and then worry about that when we know what we're going after. My main memory of this game is building so much farm I didn't have time to do anything other than water plants. Alright, yeah, we sold a bunch of potatoes there. Damn, good potatoes are worth 120? Okay, so here's what we gotta do. What we gotta do is spend a little bit of time making some fertilizer so we can get some good crops, because clearly that's gonna be a big payday. Hello, dear. I know you're just getting started as a gardener, but I wanted to give a little tip. Most crops only grow in one season. When summer arrives, your spring crops will all die out, so plan ahead. Oh. Uh-oh. Parsnips! Hooray! Oops. Don't do that. Don't do that. Baby, that's a lot of good stuff. Leveled up my farming, it looks like, too. Sweet. I'm gonna make sure I water my ancient seed. Whatever the heck that's gonna do. Yeah, standard farmer goal. Figured it was appropriate for my first time. Oof. That's a cool stump, isn't it, buddy? That is exciting. Alrighty. Successfully watered for the day. Yeah, it turns out it only takes an hour or so every morning. That's not that bad. Hit the blacksmith first. I might actually have enough money for what I want to do. Yeah, follow the plan we set out. Is this? Oh, you can actually read this. Cool. I wonder if there's other signs that'll point us out to the things we're looking for. So I'm wondering if I can get berries from that. Cool, salmon berry. Dandelion and a daffodil. Gimme. Neato. Did you give Chubbs water? We're supposed to give him water? Oh, fuck. Oh, no, buddy! He's dehydrated. I'm so sorry, Chubbs. Tell me you're still alive. Did I kill my dog? He's here somewhere. Oh, it filled when it rained. Okay, good. It's not complete negligence, at least. Someone with a backyard garden IRL, I feel the pain of the time spent watering. You ain't get yourself a sprinkler? You going out there with the hand pail every time? That's dedication, Holmes. All right, where is the blacksmith? I want to say it's up here before the mining area, right? I think it's like right up this way. That's the community center. We've yet to really do anything with. Oh, is it over here? But to hand water our gardens where I live, they do the water restrictions. Ah, sure, that makes sense. Oh, there's the carpenter, okay. You can move down from there too. But now I'm all confused. I also kind of want to talk to the mayor, see what's going on with him. I don't think I've been here yet. What? There's an interaction option, but it's not doing anything. Huh. Weird. Alright. Maybe there's supposed to be someone in there? And I just haven't activated it yet? I need to go to Joe Jamart. I think I'm supposed to go up this way, right? Oh, yeah, it might not be the right time of day. Good point. Oh, the blacksmith south of Jojo? Oh, okay, I'm completely misled. Oh, I have a map, right, yeah. Good call. Carpenters, community center, museum, Jojo Mart, Elliot's. Where the heck is it? Yeah, feel free to shout it out, because I already have danced around a lot without knowing where I'm going here. It's above the museum. Oh, it's right there. Okay. I'm just hiding right there. Thank you. I'm also very curious who the last person is that I haven't talked to. I'll run into him eventually. Alright, this is the museum, which means that's the blacksmith. There we go. Sweet. Hey, man. Upgrade tools. It is 2,000 gold. Okay, we can do that. Oh, and we need to make copper bars with the copper ore, meaning we need to make the smelter, right? I forgot about that. Which is... this, the furnace. We need stone, which we have. Okay, cool. Gonna make one of those. And I'm also gonna go fishing. Because I have inventory space, right? Yeah, we're good. Let's see if we can make some money that way today. Oh, we can crack geodes too. Nice. Okay, we'll bring the copper bars and the geodes next time. Cockle? Common saltwater clam. Oh. I don't know if I've heard that before. Friendship tab will tell you who you haven't met. Oh, social. Yeah, there we go. Look at that. Okay. Oh, there's two people I haven't met yet. We're looking for Glasses Jacket, and we're looking for the Sorcerer. Okay. Off we go. Do copper bars sell for more than copper ore? I assume so. I don't know, but that would be a safe bet. Oh, that's a mean move. So close to the perfect. Cool. You've seen Glasses Jacket, just not as a person. Oh, okay. Wait, what? Was I in my ethereal form? Do you mean like I just couldn't interact with them at the time? Or seaweed. How much that's gonna go for. Doubt very much. Might even be literally like one gold. If He runs the shop, but you only treated him as a shop, not the person. Oh, okay. That makes sense. That should be easy enough to knock out then, I guess. That's so rude! It's like a centimeter away from the perfect catch, and then it's like, whoops! Give me a perfect, damn it, I need one. I want a max cast with a perfect catch. Every time. My brain isn't happy otherwise. This is pretty peaceful. Well, I think we're going to be spending the day here. I do wonder if I can fish out a particular spot. I wonder if I should move around a little. Get him. Get him. Easy. New record. Hey, man. Ah, he got jealous. A little FOMO in there, I get it.
Hit!
Come on. Come on now. Give me this one. Give me this one. Yeah! That's better. 15-inch herring. Let's go. Out of space already, son of a bitch. Yeah, probably should have prepped a little better here. Can I eat this if I just put it on the ground and then... I think I just threw it in the ocean. That's fair. I deserve that. It's a harsh lesson to learn, but it's a good one. Oh boy. Oh boy, this guy doesn't want to get caught. This is where I just catch the leak again. Another different quality herring, huh? Okay. I think I'll toss the dandelion. In you go. Alright, one more. Chili cook-off is done, and I hope I win. I guarantee it, Pawn. And if you don't win, someone sabotaged you. That's the only explanation. And I would be very suspicious of your coworkers afterward if that were to be the case. Just give them all the stink eye if you lose afterward. Regardless, like a knowing scowl. Like this. You know you sabotaged my chili. Oh, whoops. I hit F4 again. I forgot I can't do that. Pawn's chili has Cap'n Crunch in it. I know you're joking, but what if that's secretly great? Broken CD. It's a JoJoNet. It's a JoJoNet 2.0 trial CD. They must have made a billion of these things. One day for a youth activity, when I used to be a Mormon, we would have these like youth group activities every Tuesday night or something. And one night they didn't have anything planned. So all us teenage boys were just sat in there in the church gym, because that was the thing. Because all churches should have gyms, of course, for basketball and nothing else. Anyway. A kid happened to have approximately 50 to 100 copies of the Net Zero trial CD that he'd gotten from various sources. And I believe I think it was a BB gun. So we decided to go skeet shooting with Net Zero trial CDs. And that was a good time. That was one of my favorite youth group activities that we ever did. Indoors, one kid flinging a Nat Zero trial CD in the air and the other trying to peg it with BBs before it fell to the ground. I don't think any of them broke, apart from maybe shattering upon impact, but it was a good time all the same. Boy, I really should have done better inventory prep here. Well, see you later, Daffodil. Into the ocean. Could have very easily saved most of that stuff if I just turned around, but that's too much work. Oh, you know what? There might actually be more stuff over here, too, but I don't have the inventory space for it, I guess. I don't know what I'm thinking. But I want to sell the coral. Oh, man, that stuff's actually worth some money. A little oyster over here, too? Tell you what, let's have a meal real quick. I'm sure there's one of these we can eat up. Snack bar. Yes, sir. Yeah, yeah. Thank you. My favorite full inventory Stardew combo is throwing out an item, realizing... or the item's destroyed, realizing you need it, and then confirm the item window without taking it and lose the new item. Yeah, I'm sure even having just said that now, that'll almost certainly happen to me anyway. That seems like a guaranteed eventual outcome. Here, have some of the... well, have a potato, yeah. That'll do. Eat that up, and then hopefully these are the same quality of coral. It'll save me some trouble. They are not. Unfortunately. Well, that'll have to do, I guess. We're at least going to make quite a bit of money today, presumably. That'll do. Man, three cutscenes in one day. We're cruising. All right, let's help Linus not have to dig through the trash to survive, huh? Let's maybe look out for our boy here.
Sounds like those raccoons are back again. Well, you turned up at the right moment, son. Just do an old man a favor and go around the corner and scare off those raccoons. They've been causing a real mess. Make sure you give them a good scare so they never come back. It was me. I'm sorry.
I find a lot of hot, fresh food in these cans. Stuff that will go to waste if I don't take it. You think there's something wrong with what I'm doing? Okay. You remember before? When we were talking about what are clearly the wrong choices. Here's the right one. And it's a bit of a duh. No one's gonna say that. No one's gonna say that. No one should say that.
Thanks, Baer. I knew you were an open-minded person. I feel good about what I'm doing. I'm not harming anyone.
Damn right you ain't.
You can go on home. I promise I won't rummage in George's can anymore. You can tell him you scared off the raccoons for good.
Linus should have just inherited a giant farm from his grandfather. I mean, it seems pretty straightforward, right? Oh, come on, Gus. Be a good guy. This is your time. This is your moment. This is when he says, come on in, we'll get you something warm off the stovetop, right? I know what you were doing, Linus. If you need food, just ask. I don't want anyone in Pelican Town to go hungry. That's our guy! That's a Baer clap for Gus! Hero shit. Here, I've got a basket of zucchini fritters for you. Just make sure you dip them in my spicy marinara. Go on, take it. Attaboy. Gus is goated. Absolutely.
Okay. Let's get back to home base. Make some sales, dude. This was a productive day. Oh, look, more berries. Sweet. Wonder how much those sell for. Oh, can I not take this? Nope, alright. Wish there was an option to build Linus a house on the farm. Turns out Linus was Jesus all along. And he saves you immediately prior to the rapture. And that's canon. A cannon. That's what he uses to save you before the rapture just fires you away from where it happens. It's the most efficient way. I mean, you'd think he'd have a better solution to it being the Son of God, but if it works, right? Off the parsnips go. I think I'll sell those salmon berries just out of curiosity. Same with the radish, the cockle, the seaweed. There we go. That'll do. Keeping this, keeping that, keeping the wood. Bring the copper along. Want the geodes too. And suppose that's it. Yeah. That works. Cool. Got everything watered. Looking good. I'm gonna do a little more chopping. A little more chopping before we turn in for the night. Oh, the furnace, right. Yeah, thank you. I forgot. I was forgetting something. Give me that. And then we craft up a furnace. Sweet. Right there. Right there? Right in front of the mailbox. That looks good. And then we put copper ore in there, I assume? Requires coal. Okay. Can get that. Get that in there, and then put the coal in the furnace. How do I put the coal in the furnace? Oh, I bet if I have it in the inventory, it'll work. Cool. And then you spit out copper bars, I'm assuming, right? Yeah, let's just go to bed and leave that burning overnight. I'm sure that's not dangerous at all, especially directly adjacent to my wooden house. Totally fine. Watering can and hoe proficiency, stone fence, mayonnaise machine. Oh, we can craft a sprinkler now. Sick. Good money. Made a lot from fishing, actually. Damn. Well, that flounder's worth 125, and the cockle's worth 50. Sheesh. Good stuff. Foraging money. Looking good. Looking good. We're gonna get that watering can upgrade. Although we can make a sprinkler now. I'm curious what kind of resources we need for that. Let's have a look. Got our copper bar. How you doing, sweetie? I missed you so much since you left. I hope the farming life is everything you hope for. P.S. I sent your favorite cookies. Thanks, Mom. Very chewy. Ooh, yum yum. Good old Mama. Dear neighbor, I hope you're feeling settled in your new home. I'm writing to let you know that Pierre's store is now selling fertilizers. I completely forgot to make more fertilizer, too. Holy shit. Okay, let's see. What was I gonna make? Sorry, I'm just kinda distracted by all the different options now. Need an earth crystal to make a mayonnaise machine. That sounds like fun. Use this to move down a level in the mines. Weird. Okay, I guess I'm gonna just make my own exit with a staircase. That's cool. What the heck was I looking for? Oh, sprinkler. There we go. Right. That's right. Iron bar. Okay. So probably not able to get that anytime soon, is my guess. Oh, we need 5 copper ore per copper bar as well, which means you go ahead and make up some more of those guys, and then let's go ahead and get to watering now, too. Fertilizer. That's the other thing I was going to make. I can't remember how to make that. I thought you could craft it. You can. You need sap. Right, okay. So we have sap, so we can do this. Let's go ahead and make a bunch of fertilizer now. And then we can use that on the ancient seed. Or not. That's fine, too. Oh, you have to fertilize before you plant, don't you? That's right. Okay, okay. So we'll keep that in mind for the future. I'll just go ahead and put those away for now. Let's put the sap back in there. We'll keep the copper bars in there for now. Well, actually, just gonna bring those with. More ore in there. Just gonna leave that out. Meanwhile, I guess we'll go ahead and water our crops while we're at it. Oh, wait, no, right, we were gonna upgrade that, but yeah, whatever. Have it for tomorrow, I guess. No sense waiting around. There's watering to be done. Make sure we get the copper cooking again. I'm excited to see what this ancient seed's gonna yield. I imagine it's probably gonna take a while to grow, though, because, yeah, it's only really like a little sapling right now. Cauliflower's coming. We get the bean sprouts coming up. Got some strawberries down here. All kinds of lovely variety going on. Okay. Grab that. Oh, whoops. Take it. Put that in. Refill the can. Alright. Now what do we do? Go say hi to our boy. We go fill up his water bowl because I'm not a negligent dog owner. Say, oh, you good buddy. Oh, you sweet little chubs. I can tell you. Happy boy. And then we're going to go ahead and do that because I've been meaning to do that for a minute. I'm not even sure if I've actually gone in that cave or up this way. If I did, I don't remember what was going on up there. Yoink. Water the dog. I bet he'd like it. There you go, buddy. Did he do that in response to being watered? Because that's cute. Also, I haven't watered that guy yet. There we go. All right. Let's keep making copper bars, because why not? Oh, I guess I can make more than one furnace, too. That would save me some time. It takes a bunch of copper ore to even make it, though, so yeah, maybe not. We can make a charcoal kiln, too. That's interesting. Do I want to do that right now? Not really. I want to make my wooden path, though, so I can get that going eventually. Let's not use too much of our wood, though. Let's just go with, like, 80. Yeah. I'm going to put those guys away so I don't waste any more. Keep the stone in there for now. Keep these in there for now. And the coal. Actually, we still need to build those, don't we? Keep the sap. And then once we get this copper bar, we'll get one more in there, and then I'll go over and upgrade at the blacksmith. Take your time. Take your time. No rush. We're good. All right. And we're off. Finish this path, finally. Oh, I did finish it. Okay. Never mind then. We're off for our very first upgrade. How exciting. Oh, hold up. There's a mystery event tomorrow? Apparently I missed Haley and Vincent's birthdays. It's Pam's birthday in 2 days. Let's see if I can remember to give her a gift. An invasive crab species is living in the local mine, threatening the native wildlife. These creatures are known for disguising themselves as stones. I'll pay someone to slay two of them. I think I can handle that. It's a free 150G, dude. I think I'll just head straight to the blacksmith here. Some more berries. Sweet. Where is that glasses jacket dude that was the shopkeeper? Which shop does he manage? Because I kind of want to knock that out. Oh yeah, processed geodes. 25 gold per geode? Totally worth it. That is 3 copper ore, I think. Nice. That is 4 copper ore. That's 5 copper ore. That's 10. Sweet. I'll take it. Thank you very much. And we get ourselves a copper watering can. Thanks. I'll get started on this as soon as I can. Should be ready in a couple days. Oh. That's not okay. Actually, I need that. I don't know if my crops slash dog can go a couple days without watering. I guess we'll find out. Good thing I watered beforehand, then. Okay. Well, while we're waiting on that, I guess back to the mines with Baer. Just looking at building this path here, huh? Maybe build it on the way back, actually. Here, we'll start right here. There we go. Get it going. And then it's off-center coming in the other side. Oh, it's gonna bother me. Do, 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 do. Through this way. Sweet. Well, there's a bunch of berries here. Fun. This is very satisfying to me. This makes me happy. The full path all the way up to the mine. Hey, buddy. God damn it. I gotta stop doing that. Have you come to ridicule me? Brother, I mean, I'm on your side. You know that, right? I know I just whacked you with a mallet, but don't be misled. Hey, Foos. I've been digging it, too. It's been a good time. It's already 2 in the afternoon. It's a little late to get into the mines, I guess. What else can we do today? Oh. Free leak. Thank you. How much inventory we got? You know, I think I'll just go in there anyway. I'm already here after all. Might as well. Oh, is there another leak? I didn't even notice. Oh, are you talking about the one we just got? Okay. Oh, no, there is one. Got it. Yay. Mountain fishing. Yeah, I mean, there could be new stuff up here, huh? Guess I haven't tried fishing here yet. You know what? Let's do it. Yeah. Perfect. We'll do a couple of goes, see what we can find in here. Hit! Somebody was saying... The keyboarder, I think? Were you saying something you wanted me to say when I caught a fish? Was it just fish? Like that? Because I can do that. This is a big moment. A relative of the catfish that eats a variety of foods off the lake bottom. Didn't we need a catfish for somebody, too? You caught a fish. Heyo. I swear somebody wanted me to get a catfish. It was like a town bulletin or something. I guess that's not... only a catfish. Come on. Nice. Ooh, dang. The achievement, the 2-foot carp? Holy cow, that's a big fish, dude. Okay, hang on. I think we have found the new fishing spot. Because that's 2 for 2 on some big hits, man. Most fish don't even have 1 foot. +2, no notes. think I'm pretty committed at this point. Let's see what this place has to offer. I really like this fishing minigame.
Max!
Oh, I kept forgetting my other one too. Hold on. I'll get it this time, I swear. I'll remember my cue. Yeah, this is weirdly entertaining for me. Oh, especially when... Okay, yeah, we got a tricky one here, huh? This guy doesn't want to be caught at all. This is a fight, dude. This is a battle. For an 11-inch largemouth bass. All right. So be it. I mean, fish! I missed my cue again. My bad. I won't do it this time. By which I mean I won't fail to do it. Damn, dude.
A renewal.
Man, ones here are tricky. Back.
Fish! Gear a link!
Bear hugs, please, for him. Welcome back. Tier 2 for 21 months. Welcome back, Ian. Appreciate it. Fishing is actually just my favorite part of this game. I can see why. Very tough to get the perfects on ones like those. I wonder if the difficulty you have in catching it has anything to do with the quality of the actual fish, or if the quality of the fish has anything to do with the difficulty of catching it. I also don't think I want to know either of those things. Because I think I'm happiest if I assume that both of those are true. Don't have it confirmed one way or the other. So that's how I choose to live. I insert my reality. This is just pleasant, man. The sound effects are really well done. I haven't even really... Oh, shit. Treasure. Cool. That's the first time that's happened. That's fun. And we keep the fish, question mark? Nice.
A renewal. Welcome back.
Atheist scampy sinners. Logic checks out. A diamond! Holy cow, that's gotta be good. Cool. Thank you for the bear hugs for him. Welcome on back into the pile. Thank you for the prime sub. Appreciate it. Someone should really give Linus a fishing rod. That seems like something I ought to do. I mean, yeah, he does apparently live adjacent to the best fishing spot in town. Give a man a rod and all of a sudden he becomes the wealthiest member of the village. I have a hard time pulling myself away from this, I think, dude. Apart from that driftwood, I feel like everything we've caught here has been pretty fantastic. Nice. Another carp. Still got space. Keep going. What does new ideas mean? That just means that one of our skills is ready to level up, and when we go to bed, it'll happen. Which, I didn't see it, but I'm guessing it just popped up now, so that probably means our fishing leveled up. Ask Gunther what this diamond is. Yeah, I found this diamond-shaped gem underwater. Can you help me out? I'm clueless. Man, the treasure added into here is such a clever little twist, too. This is such a good little mini-game, man. I was gonna sing the praises of the sound effects, too, because I hadn't even really noticed that up till now, but it's expertly done. Which I suppose is the sign of high-quality sound effects. It's just blend in perfectly into the experience. And of course, now the transition has been made to nighttime sound effects seamlessly. Really, just... elements of this package that I obviously would appreciate were I to get further into it in the initial playthrough, but appreciate it even more now, having given it the proper amount of time to soak in. Soggy newspaper, nice. Almost out of energy here. I think I'll let that dictate when we head home. This minigame's really loaded to the gills. Plus two. This minigame's got me hook, line, and sinker. There's another one. Hold on. I'm becoming a lot more efficient at this. Yuck, 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 yuck. Come on. I just made the pun. Don't make a liar out of me. There you go. That's a chub! That's my chubs? I can't sell that. That's a new pet. Let's go get a fishbowl for that bad boy. Probably the algae, right? Yeah. Not the best. All right, that'll do. Been so long since I've seen a first ever blind playthrough. It's just so wholesome seeing Bear's reactions. It's been fun for me, man. Yeah, I really like being able to experience something like this for the first time with the whole pile doing an excellent job of allowing me to just take it at my own pace, as you almost always do, which I appreciate quite a bit. Getting there, buddy. E-fish ent. Didn't know there were tree people involved. You never know. Oh, whoops. There we go. Okay, we watered everything, right? Yeah, we're good. So now we just gotta sell all this stuff. Stop it. Keep that. Let's go ahead and sell the driftwood, keep the skeletal tail. I'm keeping that chub. I'm keeping that damn chub. Sell the soggy newspaper, keep the copper bars. All right, good enough. The idea of fish ants is a bit waterlogged. Oh my God. All right, we can all stop now. We've reached our peak. We've reached our collective peak. We're giving that to Gunther. Let's actually keep those in the inventory so we can make a quick trip over there. I'm just going to sell these salmon berries, too. In you go. All right, before I collapse, let's hit the hay. Oh, fun. Bon, you won! Let's go! That's dope! See, I knew it. Still claim they sabotaged you, though. Keep them on their toes. All right. Pretty big payday from the fishing. Nice. Also got 169 points. Hell yeah. Oh, this is extremely convenient. The one day I don't have my watering can, it's raining. Thanks, game. Hi, me sell hats, okay, Poke? Come to old house, Poke. Bring coins. Hat mouse. Yes. Yes, I will. Got some taters. Got a couple of leeks. looking good. Everything's watered. Straight up streamer luck, dude. Yeah, for real. You gotta love it. Okay. Let me think here. We're gonna head over to Gunther real quick. Give him these geodes and the diamond. And then it's back to the mines with ye. Although, well, we have cookies. Yeah, that'll probably be enough. Got some salmon berries, too. I think we got enough provisions. Don't forget tomorrow's Pam's birthday. I will forget. Looking for a handsome young man to bring me herring. I gotta be handsome. Can you breed fish in your pond at the farm? Maybe. Seems logical. This is the kind of game that probably has some sort of animal breeding going on. Ah, I gotta wait an hour, damn. Well, I know exactly what to do to pass that time. See how the river treats us. Not as good. Not too surprising, I guess. Let's not speak too soon, though, maybe. Nice. Oh, cool. First catch. Oh, yeah, I might just get a herring and knock out that quest, huh? That's a good call. Might be some serious streamer luck. Oh, hold on. No, wait. Oh, God. Okay, hold on. We got to build this meter first and then come up here and get this thing. Oh, no. No! I lost both. Oh, total disaster. Soiled it. Top row treasure threw me off, man. A girl was looking too. Yeah, clearly the pressure was too much. Alright, that'll do. Oh, hold on. Is she... She's standing there to get out of the rain, isn't she? Oh, that's adorable. I'm gonna go inside. I just wanted a quiet moment. Oh, sure. Okay. I like that. I'm still working on your copper watering can. It won't be ready today. That's not what I want! You can't do anything else? I guess when the town's only got one blacksmith. Let me keep my expectations in check. He didn't even want to be the blacksmith. Everybody just told him he had to be because they had to fill that role in the village. Never worked with metal a day in his damn life. I'm just trying to... Just pressing the copper bars onto the watering can as hard as I can. It's not doing anything. Come back in a day or two. I'll keep trying. Really hates his high school guidance counselor. Did y'all ever take one of those job placement... survey slash test things? I feel like that's a very common trope in TV that is not actually a thing. Because I never had one of those. I don't know anybody that did. I took the what's the ASVAB? ASVAB? I don't know what that is. The test said I'd be good at whatever job I'd like, and it was absolutely unhelpful. Thanks. Thanks for the vote of confidence, algorithm. How the hell do I do this? How can I not do that? There we go. Alright, back to the mines. It told me I should be a brewmaster, and I now do corporate income tax accounting. The job aptitude test told you should be a brewmaster. That's I'm surprised they even have that as an option, because I assume the entire purpose of that was to corporatize creative minds. Is to say, no, don't try to be an artist. Work at a bank. Pay the bills. Stifle your right brain. Forever. Armed Services Vocational Aptitude Battery. Ah, I see. Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's pretty similar, isn't it? It makes more sense to me, I guess, that the military would have something like that. But that's mostly just to say, you build this plane part. Not even the planes, you build this part of the plane for the next 25 years. That's what our process has landed on. And good for you, you don't get a choice. Because you're in the military. The military. We tell you what to do and you don't question it. Oh, new idea, sweet. I got told I could do anything, so I became a disappointment. Heyo. I have a brother who was a software engineer for Amazon. So, I know a little bit about what that's like. Not quite meeting expectations. Heya! Heya! I gotta clear up some inventory space already. Let's have Mama's homemade fresh baked cookies. Because even if I'm not a software engineer, at least Mama still loves me enough and make me some cookies. Yum, yum, yum. Delicious. I've already got a full goddamn inventory again here, too. Eat the algae? Yeah. That seems right. Are you folks the did you hear what your brother did type 2? Now, I say that while also knowing I should add the caveat of my parents are still incredibly supportive and wonderful people. It's not like they're doing anything like that at all. That's in my mind. All the comparisons are happening up here. My parents are actually quite proud of me for what I've done. You know what? So am I, damn it. I'm pretty happy with the pile. Hell, I'm pretty stoked that I'm still here, man. That's more of a measure of quality than anything, is the fact that I'm still kicking. Sheesh. Come on, ladder. Come on, ladder. Where are you at? I want to get down to 20 at least tonight. Now that I know it, I wasn't actually being forcefully stopped from proceeding. Tommy proud? I don't know. Let's find out. Not sure Tommy is capable of feeling anything other than existential dread. At least that's the impression his face constantly gives off. What do you think, Tommy? You proud of the pile? You proud of all we've done? Nah, yeah, he's just kind of staring off into the distance as he does. We'll check in with him later. Maybe he's got to think about it a little bit. Are you proud of Tommy? What's not to be proud of? He's the perfect channel mascot. He makes folks comfortable. I always feel better with Tommy around. Stop it. Now this part of this game is absurd to me. I've asked this multiple times, so I'm pretty confident that it's actually the case now, that you cannot drop items on the ground apart from doing that, and then very quickly apparently navigating out of the menu so that you can walk away from it and get rid of it. And people are going to say, just put it in the garbage. I know. I recognize that. What should be an option, and what I am blown away is not actually an option, is just click on the floor, put item on the floor. If that's not a mod, I'll be shocked, dude. Like, that has to be something that somebody besides me is, like, frustrated does not exist. I caught you, Grim. Shame. Shame. Practice waffle. Thank you for the 14. Thank you for the prime. Welcome back in. Anyway, yeah, let's trash that, I guess. Thank you for the bear hugs form. Welcome back in. Walk near the item you want to pick up. Throw something out of your inventory and the other item gets hoovered up. But what if it's a piece of quartz that you have to actually interact with on the ground? Then, pray tell, then, what's a bear to do? Just give up and cry? I'm good at that. It's already getting late. The internet told me how far off the inventory you move them affects how far away they drop. Oh, really? Nope. That'd be nice, but nope. That would be a solution. Looking... Oh, there we go. I was gonna say, looking a little more unlikely we're gonna be able to actually do this tonight. Get rid of the dandelion? I don't really want to do that. I guess I could just eat this fish. It's probably fine. Well, let's eat the cave carrot first. That was a bit of a waste today, too. Here we go. See what this guy is. Oh, it's an earth crystal. Nice. I needed that. Yeah. 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 Gotcha. No transform for you. Getting a lot of copper today. Ah, son of a bitch. So fast. I wonder if they keep the damage you dealt to them in their first form when they do that. Oh, there's one of these guys. That's nice. One of two. Done. Right, I think we got like one more hour we can safely spend in here before it's time to bounce. Let's eat the dandelion. Topaz, nice. Come on, give us one more ladder here. Come on now. So I feel like we have got to be... Oh, nice. How convenient. Got to be really close. I want to say we're probably at like floor 19 now. Nice. Get rid of these guys. Yeah. All right. Steel small sword. Somehow worse than our club. Plus 2 speed, but... I mean, someone probably wants this, right? Get rid of the coal, I guess. Cave fishing. Oh, yeah. Cool. I will do that. Assuming this sticks around. I'm not certain it does, but... give it a look tomorrow, I guess. All right. We got some good stuff to sell today. Got geodes and a couple of minerals to bring over to Gunther in the morning. Might as well keep going with the path, right? Oh, I guess I could have made inventory space that way, too. I didn't even think about it. Goodness, how was I dealing with half this inventory space before? I think I'm actually going to have to prioritize that other backpack. Don't I have that exact quest already? Must be for somebody else. Looks like I might want to consider doing some fishing tomorrow, too, just to knock those quests out. Have I found out anything about what Pam likes? It's her birthday tomorrow. I haven't given any gifts, so I guess we just gotta try something. Also, I have no idea where she's at. Oh, she did spike the punch, that's true. Yeah, that's telling. Maybe we can get her some alcohol of some kind. I'm gonna sell these taters. I'm gonna sell the smallmouth bass. Sell the berries. And probably can sell the leeks as well. I'm curious what these slimes are going to go for. Same with the bug meat. I just want to give that a go. And then let's get some coal so we can fire up the furnace for the copper ore. Or copper bars, rather. And I guess that'll do. We're keeping the earth crystal. We're going to eventually build a... how do we build the mayonnaise thing? Wood and a copper bar. We can just do that right now. Once this is whipped up. Oh, I didn't accept the quest before, apparently. Okay.
Mayonnaise machine.
Everybody needs a mayonnaise machine. Oh no! Oh no! Oops. I guess it was a matter of time until that happened. Can craft a life elixir now. Neat. Slime's worth a decent amount. 25 apiece, and the bug meat for 8. Or sorry, no, it's 5 apiece, not 25. Cool. That'll do. Now you know your time limit. Yeah. Oh, I guess I just fully restore energy anyway. And my copper watering can is ready. Nice. Let's go grab it. You're lucky I found you last night. You were unconscious and someone was searching your pockets. I have no idea how much money they took. They ran away as soon as I approached. Be more careful. They robbed me at night? Oh my god. Okay. I've got some new items in stock. A deluxe fishing pole and some bait that you can attach to it. You can use bait to make fish bite faster. Cool. Somebody came to my house. I know, they're on my property, and they're robbing me fucking while I'm asleep. Jeez. Take it easy. Okay, so apparently these regrow, too, which is really cool. And I'm curious how much a bean's going to sell for, so I'm just going to go ahead and pop this into the box here. Grab this parsnip. Do the same. And let's go grab our watering can and get these guys sorted. Also, let's bring some copper and see if I can't upgrade a different thing, too. In fact, here, let's go ahead and fire these up real quick. How the heck do you use this thing? I don't seem to be able to interact with it. I guess we'll find out eventually. Buddy. Come back in a sec, okay? I gotta go get my watering can so we can fill up your bowl. Okay, then we need to do this twice more. So we have the 5 copper bars. I would water these if I could. I guess I can just chop trees down or something. Oh, no, you like your tree, don't you? Yeah, I don't want to mess with your tree. Let's get this pine. This is going to be a good day, dude. I think I am going to go fishing today as well so I can knock out that herring quest. There's probably a way to see what quests you have active right now, right? Crafting animals, collections, options, skills, social. Is there not a way? Oh, duh, the journal. Cost us anything. Sweet. Okay, one more bar. Let's make ourselves a couple of snacks here, too. I think I got the resources for that. Just the one, I guess. Good enough. Put that away. I'm hoping I can sell this, I guess? I suppose I can just do that now. Click and then... Oh, I can't sell that, apparently. Okay, never mind. Let's put it away, I guess. Put the topaz away. Keep that. Put that away. Put that away. Put those away. Put the copper away. Keep the cookout kit. I'm going to gift this daffodil to Pam. See how she likes that. All right, let's do it. Some bear dance slash vibes. Thwack. Thwack. There's so many berries. What are you doing over here? We're very lucky to have a library in such a small town. That's a true facts, dude. Yeah, no doubt. She's got a good perspective. Oh, baby, our first upgraded tool.
Yes!
You received a copper watering can. All right, let's process some geodes. Ooh, what's that? Sandstone. And limestone. Nice. Thanks, dude. Oh, right. Hold on. I want you to upgrade. Let's upgrade the pickaxe. Oh, no. I spent my money on the geodes. Shit. Well, that was dumb. There's gotta be a way I can just make 60 bucks real quick, right? Oh, I can do the quest. Let's catch a herring real fast and we'll give it to Haley. Also, I can meet that last dude. Where was that shopkeeper? I must have not noticed if anybody answered that last time. Glasses jacket. Where's he? What shop is he running? Oops. Which guy is it? This dude. He looks like he runs a museum, but apparently not. If only you hadn't gotten robbed on your porch last night. God, yeah, that is actually the case, huh? I would have had enough. Crap. I don't think it's this one.
A nominal pittance.
Pony of Shadow. Gift him a sub to Tokyo Wartooth. Please give him some bear hugs for the gift. He appreciate that. Woman of the pile. Are you saying he looks like a nerd? Yeah, a little bit. Oh, that's the main dude. I've talked to him like 5 times. Welcome to Pierre's. How can I help you? I noticed you needed to complete your journal entry by speaking to me, so I'm forcing the issue. Also, here's the other guy you haven't talked to yet, just to knock it all out in one go. Oh, no, never mind. That's the JoJo dude, isn't it?
Ahem.
Come and get it, folks. Coupons for 50% off your purchase at JoJo Mart. 50%? Well, any taker? This is just... Bro, this is in bad taste. Morris was already pretty up there on the shit list, but he's kind of locking in his slot as the only person there. Oh, no, but they're just... Oh, they're eating it up. Right out of his hand. Oh, no. But I can't match those prices. I'd be selling at a loss. Scum. Okay. If it wasn't already the villain, coming in here to rub it in his face, it must be so difficult for you to lose your loyal customers like that. But can you blame them? JoJo Corporation is clearly the superior choice. Here's my impression of Morris. This is Corpo Dick right here. This is Morris. Sorry, that's a bit harsh for Stardew Valley. My bad. That's taking it a bit too far. Soon the whole team town will realize that. You're a ball swallower? I hope so. What a piece of garbage. Alright. Nothing wrong inherently with swallowing balls. I just want to say that. I just, you know, in this instance, it's just more of a metaphor for boot licking. when ball sucking's a metaphor for boot licking, I don't know. That seems like it might be a bit circuitous of a route to take there, Bear. What was I doing with this dude? Oh, I just wanted to talk to him. That's right. I didn't even need to buy anything. Give someone a gift. I can do that. I was planning on it. I finished my introductions, right? So I guess that's already done. And didn't even get anything? What's the point of that? Waste of damn time talking to people. All right. We gotta find Pam. Give her a daffodil. Pam! Where is Pam at? I have no idea where Pam's at. You get the reward of friendship. The reward was the friends we made along the way. Boo! Weak. I wanted money. That's the title of my autobiography, The Circuitous Route from Ball Sucking to Bootlicking. I'd buy it. No, right. Impression of Morris is this, because this is like a CEO of JoJo Mart, and then you know you get it. I just felt like that was important for you to see too. She knows all about it, dude. She's a Stardew vet. She's the conductor of the fuck Morris train. Pam. Is that the new subscriber notification? I've used the same one for a minute. Really gotta mix it up.
Daffy girl.
Come boop your snoot. Come boop your snoot. You don't want it? Come here. Daffy, the camera will focus eventually.
Oh, you know what? I think I turned off the autofocus on this thing, didn't I? That's the problem. Hang on a second. Turn that back on. Oh, no, it is on. It's just terrible. It's just really bad.
Chips! Oh, he's so handsome.
And there's Tommy.
Taffy, come here!
Taffy, girl.
That blur in the background there, that's Taffy, and eventually when the camera decides it wants to focus on what's actually in frame, maybe we'll get to see her. Yeah, the light is not doing me any favors here. I can't figure out why it does not want to focus at all, though. Hey, down here.
Hello? Do you recognize that that's a giant blur? Webcam?
Maybe it's just not a great webcam. Maybe ultimately that's the conclusion we have to land on, is that it's only really good for blasting Tommy's face off into the ether. Starfisher! 122 months is an absurd amount of months to be upon the bear pile, but I do appreciate it. Give him some bear hugs, please, for that. Thank you. The Stardew has been fantastic. Been a big fan of this game. Right now we're trying to find Pam, having no real idea of where she might actually be. This is her birthday, and I gotta give somebody a gift. Can I get a push to Pam? A Pam push? Oh, she's probably in the saloon. She do be drinking. Although it is 3 in the afternoon, but that, I mean, that'd be about when I'd feel justified, I guess. Jojo Mart? Oh, yeah, it's true. They just gave out all those 50% coupons, huh? She might be there. Pam. Was that? Where is it again? Oh, right, yeah. Thank God I somebody reminded me there's a map. This sign is still so... oh, man. So off-putting. Oh, no Pam in here. Nice to see it empty. That makes me happy. Yeah, we checked the saloon, we checked the Jojo Mart. Where's her trailer, Bennett? I guess I checked the map for that too, huh? Emily and Kaylee, Jody, Kent, and Sam, Pierce Store, Town Square, the Saloon, Mayor's Manor, Marnie's Ranch, Leia's Cottage. Trailer's right below you. Oh, there it is. Pam? No Pam. Where the hell's Pam? It's her birthday, she's nowhere to be found. Oop. Come on. Oh, that's the mayor's house, right? Yeah, that's right. Oh, she's going to the saloon as we speak. I'm just trying to chase her around. Okay. Here we go. That's her, right? I gotta put my damn club away, dude. I'm gonna keep chopping people up. I've been looking forward to this beverage all afternoon. Perfect. There you go, Pam. Nope. Give it to her. You remember my birthday? I'm impressed. Thanks. Hey, we did it. Terrific. Perfect! That's exactly what we needed. Hey, a financial gain. There's our incentive. Now you're getting it, game. Right. So now... hopefully the blacksmith's still open. It might be closed. Yeah, as hard as it is to believe, Lo, I have never played this. Alright, a little too late for that, unfortunately. It'll take all damn day to get to Pam, I guess. Let's see if I can find that herring for Haley. A Herring for Haley is also the name of the novel I'm writing. Coincidentally. The arcade games in this are tough. I was actually playing a little bit of the Prairie one yesterday, and that was also impressive. Like, I feel like I could spend a lot of time just playing that little roguelike mini game. Although I got my butt kicked at like the third level, I think, so yeah, gonna be tough if I want to try to clear that at any point. I was gonna say we're probably not gonna go mining for the next couple of days, given the fact that I'm likely going to upgrade my pickaxe here. But we did also just unlock the cave pond, so I could go fishing in there for a bit if I'm curious to see what they've got. Oh, nice. Fishing bait. How do we actually use this? We go like... just like put it in the water or something? How do you use bait? I need a better fishing rod. Okay. Do you upgrade the rod too, or do you have to buy a new one? Come on, come on. Get there. There we go. Nice. Gotta buy a new one. Okay. A lot of smallmouth bass here. I'm wondering if there's even anything else available. Maybe that'd be the place to catch the herring. And nighttime. That was a quick day. Come on, perfect. Come on. Nice, sneaky devil. Yeah, it's all smallmouth bass here. Let's go try something else. In real life, herring are an ocean fish. We'll see if it holds water here. Ha ha ha. I'm gonna be checking the shore more, I guess. I think these clams are worth like 50 a pop, so absolutely worth it to swing by here and get the ocean salvage, I guess. Is that an urchin? Oh, I got a full inventory too, damn. Oh, right. I was gonna swing by Gunther's, I forgot. Well, let's have a field snack, I guess. Make some space there. Sea urchin, starred sea urchin too, sheesh. I might just get rid of this bait since I can't use it now. Oh, I can eat the algae, never mind. There we go. There we go. And then need another spot. Oh yeah, we have our copper water pod now, I forgot. Don't forget the dig spots, three little worms wiggling in the ground. Oh, is that what that is? You can get that with like a hoe or a pickaxe or something? That's cool. I might just get rid of the stone here, I guess. Yeah, let's just do that. Got a home, okay. See how many of the same quality of coral we can get as well. Nope. All right. Okay, I think that'll have to do for today. Filled up the inventory again. I gotta make sure I come out with a lot more spaces next time. Keep filling up way too quick. Let's not collapse on the ground again tonight either. The precious, perfect amount of money we get. In real life, there's a river herring called an alewife. That's an anadromous fish. Lives in the ocean and goes up rivers into fresh water to lay eggs. That's fun. That's a fun word. Anadromous, I'm assuming, means capable of living in both salt and fresh water. Based on context clues. That's a fun word. All right, what are we putting away here? Do the bass, do the urchin, do the coral, do the clams. Probably keep the rest, maybe get rid of the berries. And then we're still wanting to take the stuff to Gunther, so we don't have to put that away. We'll put the bait away, put the wood away for now. Yeah, all that stuff's going to Gunther, so we'll just keep that in the mix. Anadromous is the name of a Lovecraft god. I would also believe that. I would believe both. I didn't water my crops today, did I? I gotta knock that out real quick. So the watering can now does not target any more than one tile still? Question mark? Oh, you can hold it down. Cool. That's neat. Okay, right on. making him big in it. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna get that ancient seed. There we go. All right, good enough. Everybody knows about the water can power attack, right? Yeah. Oh, nice foraging for the day. Okay. Yeah, we really got to hit up that beach. That was a cool 600 just from urchins and coral. That's crazy. 200 just for that one urchin. All right. Yes, sir, Lemony. I've been loving it. Oh. Oh, man, I really thought it was snow for a second. That's fun. So that, to me, indicates the imminent conclusion of spring. I need fresh cauliflower for a recipe I want to make. Could you bring me one? Sure can, Jody. Got that ready in like a day, I think. Let's see how far this can go. Just the three? Okay. Acceptable. That's pretty neat. I don't know how much of a time save it is, though. Feels fairly similar to the time I was spending otherwise. Well, there we go. Bring Jody a cauliflower. Mr. Taffy, what scent we feeling this month? Honeysuckle, raspberry, or watermelon lime? Honeysuckle. That's a tough choice, though. Oh, yep, gotta water the dog. Don't forget. Very important. It's nice for crops you can't walk over. Ah, sure, yeah, I am just realizing that now with the beans, right? So I'm gonna want, okay, so I'm getting an idea of how we're gonna build things out in the future, where we're gonna want to have a walking path down separating three rows of bean stalks. That'll be good. All right. Let's see, let's go back to Gunther. And then let's hit up the blacksmith and upgrade our pickaxe. And then let's head down to the beach. I think we'll just spend the day fishing, trying to find a herring. Sounds about right. Becoming more familiar with the layout now. Oh, nice. Thank you. All right, buddy. Let's upgrade this pickaxe, huh? Steel watering can, oh my. Oh, a copper trash can. When trashing an item, you reclaim 15% of the value. Huh. That's kind of neat. Definitely want to get the pickaxe going, though. And over to the museum. Got some goodies for you, bud. Nice. All right. That'll do, I guess. Off to the ocean. This is Haley, right? Nah, it's Penny. Okay. Who informed me of the option to dig in the dirt? Which I've really yet to do, I guess. It didn't even really occur to me that was an option out here. Oh no! Mom's making lentil soup tonight! Sorry, Vincent. Oh, interesting. Looks like there's like a 24-hour timer on these things. But not all of these things? Okay. if I can fish in these little puddles. No. Okay. Muscle. It's random what spawns at the beach. Okay. I do now, Foos. Yeah, I think that was what Ares was just telling me about. Gotta look for the wormies. It's a herring day. I ain't leaving here till I get myself a herring. Actually, you know what? I bet I can already afford the new fishing rod. Or I'm likely close to it. I'm gonna go look into that. Oh, well, there we go. Mission accomplished, I guess. See ya. All done. I do want to see if I can get that new fishing rod too, though. And then I think I'll do some cave fishing. See what comes out of that. Yo, bad news, Baer! But great news for the pile. Thank you for the 10 gifted. That's extremely generous. Appreciate that. Welcome to the pile, everybody. Love from Australia. We love Australia. That's where my good friend Indie Mouse resides. Well, I assume the bamboo pole is better, right? Got a fiberglass rod, too, though. Oh, this looks like what you need. I'm assuming that little hook thing is what you'd interact with to put the bait on there. Yeah, I think I've already got a bamboo pole, don't I? Okay. Oh, you can get a fish tank. Oh, fun. I'm going to put a chub in a fish tank. I'm going to have two chubs in this game. Okay, so we're saving up for 1,800 for a fiberglass rod. Can do. Can do kangaroo. Look at the more expensive one. There was a more expensive one? I thought the fiberglass one was the most expensive one. Alright, let's go cave fishing. See what we can get. Eventually I'll finish this path over here too. What the heck are we supposed to do over here? I totally forgot. Does that like do something about the rat problem or something? I haven't even gone in here yet. Oh. Wingdings. Okay. Interesting. Oh, it doesn't even say anything about this yet. Maybe we deal with this later. Y'all are hearing wind chimes, right? Because that's just, like, faint enough to make me wonder if I'm hearing that, like, outside my house. Don't make me feel crazy. You don't need to help me with that. Not hearing it? What the hell? Maybe I am a nut. Again, we kind of already knew that. Cave fishing. I assume. If it's still there. There we go. That's not exciting. Come on, you can do better than that. Kitten!
Welcome back.
Welcome back. 82 months. Please give him some bear hugs for the very long-term resubscription. Welcome back. Appreciate you. Did know that, Bears. Yeah, I'm actually kind of working on that. Cave jelly. Fun. Ooh. Wow. Plus one luck, too. Damn, that's cool. Chow down, dude. Eat it straight out of the water. Yummy. Oh, whoops. Yeah, it works, I guess. Please show him some love with the bear hugs. Thank you so much for the long-term resubscription. Welcome back in. Need the fiberglass rod to get fish out of here? Oh, really? Bummer. Yeah, why am I getting some more cave jelly? I'll give it one more shot. It's certainly taking a while to catch anything at all. I suppose it is possible to get lower in the caves without your pickaxe. Oh, hold on, here we go. There's something on the line. What's that? Ghost fish. 33-incher. Oh, shit. I'm staying right here, dude. Look at that. I bet that's worth a pretty penny. Only difference between the normal three rods is the slots on them. Okay, that's good. White algae, too. Interesting. Oh, I gotta give the herring to Haley. I should probably do that soon. So I don't lose the opportunity. I'm assuming she probably doesn't want it a day old. Come on. All right. That'll do for now. Let's go deliver our herring. Good to know that's available, though. I think I'll probably just do a little more fishing to finish off the day here, too. You're not Haley, right? No, you're Maru. Where is Haley's house? Jody, Kent, and Sam, Emily, and Haley. Okay, it's two Willow Lane, right down there. Straight shot down. Board quest usually timed. Oh, I don't have it anymore. You're right. Darn. Well, all right then. More fishing for me, I guess. That works. I'm assuming this luck affects your fishing. Probably a better chance at getting better catches. Nice way to wrap up the evening here. Night fishing deserves a quiet night. I caught a carp at the dock's edge. Threw it back for later. It's got to be like the 12th night swimming rendition I've done, which would amount to about one a year, I guess. So that seems reasonable. It's acceptable. You did seem to catch a rare fish immediately after slurping some cave jelly. Yeah, checks out. So far, though. Come on, buddy. Hook it up. We got 3 minutes left of premier fishing. Certainly we got something, right? It's really slowing down here, though, man. I feel like we were catching fish way quicker before. I just had to say something. There we go. All right. We'll go till about 10:30, 11. Can use a little more money anyway. In fact, I think if I'm able to fish like two or three more of these, might be enough to get the fiberglass rod tomorrow too. If not, I'm sure I can sell some stone and wood or something and get there. You must gripe to get the best drops.
Why doesn't it ever give me the best fish? This game never lets me have anything nice.
Or did you mean grip? I gotta firmly grasp the rod. You keep him right down there. That's fine with me, dude. I'll take it. Firmly grasp it! That ought to do it. Hey, nice. I got some new ideas to sleep on, huh? Hell yeah. All right, well. Minute and a half left of luck. Might as well use that up, right? Come on, one more big boy. New herring record. 25-inch herring. Let's see it. Oh, he's a fighter. He means business. Oh, boy. Oh, we might have the big catch after all. Ooh, this is tough. Come on, get in there. Get in there. Halibut! Oh, all right, cool. You know what? A little more luck. Why not? A little more luck. We're here. Let's do it. Max cast. I got time. Come on, man. One more. Papa needs a fiberglass rod. Gimme. Just be patient. Perfect catch. So close. Baited me. Hilariously. Another herring. All right, that'll do. That'll do. Sprint back home. Late night, brother. Let me hook you. If you really want to get the fish biting, make sure you put some bait on your hook.
Run! Sprint home, young bear. Lest your pockets be picked once more.
This is actually good for me. To gauge how long it takes to run from the dock back home. Important lesson. Glad we built this path, too. All right, got it all watered. Let's sell some of these here fish. I'll sell the bait, too. See how that goes. All right, man. That ought to be good. Hit the sack. Fishing rod proficiency, a crab pot, and we can make the dish of the sea. Cool. Tell me it's enough. Just enough. Perfect. Perfection. Yeah, we got our cauliflower, right? Yeah, for Jody.
My sources tell me you've been poking around inside the old community center. Why don't you pay me a visit? My chambers are west of the forest lake in the stone tower. I may have information concerning your
rat problem. His name is Rasmodius, of course it is.
Cauliflower.
Hell yeah. How convenient that we were growing that. Alright, we're going straight to Jody. It was right there. Let's do it. Selling the bait won't catch much fish. We did already have bait, though, thankfully, so. It was just extra. Oh, yeah, I guess I should have watered, too. We'll get it done. Jody! Jody and the Pussycats. Get your veggies. Oh, goodness. All right, let's go buy the rod first then, I guess. Well, she's not necessarily in her house, I guess, but... safest bet, anyway. Oh, wait, we have to go this way, don't we? Whoopsie. God, I really hope I get, like, a bike or something at some point. I don't think you do, though, do you? I'm pretty sure you're just stuck walking around all the time. Get used to the idea, Bear. Nothing on the beach. Oh, there's worms, though. Hold on. Cool. That's fun. Well, kill some time, I guess. Nobody wants to get going early, huh? Where are my early risers at? Where are my folks whose bowels wake them up at 6:30 to 7 a.m. every day, regardless of what they want? That's me. Ooh, an anchovy. Oh, no, that's just a... right, yeah, we've had that before. It's a new record for the inches, though. Bear's gonna be looking for walk, speed, or bike mods after this. I might. I feel like that's against the spirit of the first playthrough, though. Gotta deal with the in-game restrictions, as is. Android alien! Back. Made me miss my damn fish, but thank you for the resub. Welcome back in. Appreciate the bear hugs for him. Welcome back to the pile. Drag him back down to the bottom. Reassume them into the mass. All right, that'll do. That'll do. He's not even here yet. Gotta wait for him to actually show up. God damn it. Hold on, might as well go over here while we're here. Nothing new, huh? Alright. I'm relying on that too much, I guess. This is where, Elliot lives, right? Yeah, okay. Alright, cauliflower delivery. Who's hungry? I believe this is her. Penny's a sweet girl. She's been Vincent's teacher for a while now, and he really loves her. Here's what you wanted. Oh, that looks so delicious. Thank you. This is just what I wanted. It's going to be perfect for my yellow curry. Hooray! All right. Mission accomplished. Now we go back down to the dock. I haven't actually tried this yet. Yeah, makes sense. Yellow curry, yeah, it's got me. It's got me craving lunchtime. Please be here. God damn it. At Leads up to a little sleeping cubby. Can I shout at him? A tackle box. Yeah, that ain't gonna help. Oh, fun. You can change your bobber style. I'm gonna be a happy face. Is there a service bill? Here it is. I just smashed my club through the glass pane. I'll get his friggin' attention. You pass Willie on the way here at like 6 a.m. My man is not respecting his own business hours, that's for damn sure. Alright, well, let's just go water our crops and come back and hopefully he'll be there at that point. Lazy ass. How's the shop even open if he's not there? I mean, it's just an honor system, I guess, which if you live in a small town, I suppose. Pretty tough to get away with stealing anything. He sees me out there the next day with his fiberglass rod just casting, and I'm like, what? Did you steal that? No. It's mine. I just haven't been using it yet. Yet that's true, right? Yeah, I get robbed in the middle of the night in front of my own damn farm. But no, apparently I'm not allowed to steal a single rod from Willie's fishing shack. Double standard around here, dude. Got it from JoJo, yeah. See, that's what should be allowed. I don't know why you're not allowed to steal from JoJo Mart. That certainly seems like the morally respectable thing to do. Yeah, once we set this up better, I'm sure this is going to be a really nice upgrade, but for now it's kind of negligible, I guess. This ancient scene is taking a long-ass time. Hopefully that ends up being something nice. Let's see. We're still waiting on the pickaxe. I guess we just go back down to Willie's again. There's not really much else to do right now. Refill this guy real quick. Oh, water for the pup. Yep. Can't forget that. My poor thirsty boy. There he goes. I think I'm probably going to build a footpath that kind of goes like, I'm assuming probably like coming through here, left to right, and then probably like up a row, up a row, up a row. Yeah, it seems like I'll probably do something like that. Although I might want to build a gravel path instead, since apparently that's easier to maintain. Where will the roller coaster go? By the Ferris wheel. Right next to the tilt-a-whirl. Somebody said something about the wooden path degrading, but I'm not sure if that's actually a thing. Okay, well, if he's fishing here, that means he's not selling goddamn fishing rods. Okay, so your store hours are just a lie, then? It's just whenever you feel like being there? Cool, dude. Yeah, all right. I'll just see if I can get lucky with when you decide to be in your shack. Oh, that's cute. They interact with each other. I like that. It is the weekend. I didn't see no specification, dude. It says 9 to 3, 7 days a week. Or your money back. Or the fiberglass rod is free, I believe, are the exact specifications. Alright, well. I'll do some more basic cave fishing, I guess. See how that treats us for the evening. It's open hours, not working hours. Okay, that I suppose I can forgive. Can't fight that. Was there something else in the Adventure Guild I was supposed to do, or are they just looking for all those monsters slain? Can he, like... Oh, right, yeah, we can buy a new weapon here, but... Yeah, not really. really necessary, having gotten the wooden club so early on. Sneakers have some defense on them. Okay, that's nice. It's a wall sword. Topaz ring for defense. Yeah, I don't think I need any of that stuff. Where's the list again? Here it is. We're almost there on cave insects. Only 20 more of those. What was that? That sound that just played. I feel like I missed something. Okay, down we go. I wonder if I'll be able to break through that purple rock when I have my copper pickaxe upgrade. Probably worth a look. It's more white algae. It didn't actually say how much that sold for. I'm curious. Yeah, can we get some smiley faces in chat for whenever we're fishing now? That feels appropriate.
Max!
Just a happy little bob and lure. Just a happy guy. Having a good time. Come on now. Alright. Does seem like it's still pretty rare, I guess. To get a fish in this cave pond with this rod. So hopefully Willie feels like working tomorrow and we can upgrade it. Yeah, not getting a lot of luck in here, I guess. I just noticed this. Does this show up on every floor and I didn't see it until now? I had no idea this little floor marker was here. That's funny. I've just been guessing the whole time. Oh, I feel silly. Come on, one more. One more. One real fish. How about that? Just to make me believe that it's still possible down here. No? That just feels like a middle finger. I fished a middle finger. Alright, well. Not exactly the day we had in mind, but that'll do, I guess. Does mean we get the copper pickaxe tomorrow, so that'll be a good way to pick things back up. Should be some good new progress in the morning. I think this will probably wrap it up for this session of Stardew, though. Feels like a good stopping point. And thanks for watching, everybody. This has been a blast. I'm loving this, and I'm very glad folks are into it. Absolutely going to play some more tomorrow. Buying one flounder at 3x market value is Demetrius. Ooh. I gotta take that. Also, it might be someone's birthday. Hold on. Oh, it's Shane's birthday. I have no idea who that is. I'm not going to worry about that. We're going to go to bed. Sell a few of these things here. Drunk at the bar. Okay, yeah. Meh. We'll get them next year. Sell that Joja Cola. Get rid of these guys. Get rid of the seaweed, the anchovy. That'll do. Yeah, I'll just sell the cauliflower as well. I'm curious to see how much that's going to sell for. And keep the rest. Looking good. Already watered our crops. Let's get to bed. Good stuff. All right. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you in the next one.